What's up, everybody? My name is Frostie, and welcome to Season 2 of Single Player Tarkov. If you're returning from Season 1, hey, how's it going? Welcome back. I love you. And if you are new here and have no idea what Single Player Tarkov is, I also love you. Hey, how's it going? And let me briefly explain what this is. Single Player Tarkov, or affectionately known as SPT, is a modded version of Escape from Tarkov that allows the user to play offline with progression, but it is 100% and completely separate from your normal Tarkov account. It does not synchronize, it does not carry over, it is a separate game. This means that we are able to enjoy what I feel and believe to be the core of Tarkov, which is the survival aspects of the game and not having to deal with a lot of the MMO aspects of the game, such as a player-run economy, possibility of cheaters, just having to deal with online stuff in general. Now for this season, I have slightly changed the rules of my playthrough. So rule number one is we will not have insurance. Insurance kind of defeats the purpose of a single player game. I will always get it back since there are no other players to pick up my gear and leave the map with it. Rule number two is I am not allowed to use my scav run. Money and loot can only be earned by risking gear on my PMC. It would be way too easy to earn money and gear by being able to run a scav every 10 to 15 minutes. Rule number three, no flea market, except if I need an item for a quest such as a key. Last season, we ran into a massive issue where I needed keys for quests and I just couldn't find them. There were multiple 4 to 6 hour streams where I just could not get keys. So that is a rule we are changing for this season. And rule number four, I am not allowed to leave the map until I have completed a quest where at least 10 minutes remain on the raid timer. I have scrapped the rule about having to go to a different map each time I do a raid because it made questing last kind of just way too long. There was a lot of times where I was on a single set of quests that I had to go to a single map, so I had to make up a reason to go to a different map. We're axing that rule for this season. This season will end when I get Kappa or when I run out of stuff to do. There is the new Lighthouse Keeper. He is in this game and does have a quest line along with a number of cutscenes. Now, it's not finished, as many players of Live Tarkov know. You do reach a sort of end point with the Lighthouse Keeper where he just no longer gives you anything to do. So if we do happen to reach that point in the season and Escape from Tarkov has not updated to add more things, the season will then end, or we can put it on a hiatus until there is something else for me to come back and do. There's also a possibility of me downloading mods for additional quests and running through those if we reach that point, but that is so far down the road that we're not gonna worry about it right now. We're just gonna gear up and we're gonna get into our first raid of Season 2 of Single Player Tarkov. All right, and I am already ready to go. We got our gear set up. We got our quests ready. The first map we're gonna go to is actually going to be Woods. So we're gonna do Introduction and then try and get Debut and Shortage done all in the same time. That is a lot of asking, but we are capable of doing it all in Woods. So let's go ahead and get into our first raid. All right, here we are, first raid of the season on beautiful Woods. Well, this is gonna be easy. We are near the plane crash, which means we are near the Introduction to Jaeger quest. So what we can actually do is we're going to get the letter and then look at that. First Lua. We're going to get the letter. We're going to head into the FOB. And then we'll probably... do we have to go to Outskirts? We do. Shoot. That's okay. Oh my god. Two Salewas right off the bat. I'm definitely dying. Okay. You know what? I'm going to just do this for posterity. We got our letter. And you know what? Now that I actually have two Slaywas there, I kind of just want to... Do we just... Yeah. I'm actually going to head a long way around. I'm going to avoid the FOB. Since we already have to get to the outskirts to get out, we're going to head to the USEC camp. Loot that up a bit, and then we'll take a sort of direct route past ZB-14 towards Outskirts. Now, I love some of the changes that they made in patch 13. The weight system, stamina system are so much better. We're actually going to be able to loot stuff and not just immediately have to crawl everywhere, which is great. Go ahead and change this. I like the little chevron instead of the dot on this one for some reason. Now with SPT 3.5, the team has done a phenomenal job in sort of updating and optimizing their... There's somebody up there. Optimizing their code. Whereas we used to get a bunch of hitches when AI would spawn in. Those are pretty much gone at this point. Which is great. Because I'll have no idea now. When stuff has been spawned in. Come on, buddy. There you go. See if maybe we can get our first scav over here. Thought I heard somebody up here. Come check for treasure. Treasure. Now, Ballstate Games has also changed their AI quite a bit. So we might not get completely destroyed as we did last season on many, many occasions. Shit. That was killer. That was killer in woods on the sniper scav mountain, by the way. Oh God. I jinxed it. Oh, I jinxed it so bad. Definitely a single player Tarkov. All right. We're going to gear up. We're going to go right back in. Screw it. Okay, let's try that again, shall we? Where did it put? Oh. Okay. Let's loot some pressure shack, and then we'll head to the USEC camp, loot that, head to the Jaeger stash. Or not Jaeger stash, the, whatchamacallit, the letter. We'll hit the FOB, and then we'll get out. Ooh. All right, probably just sell all that. Actually, let me grab this because I'm gonna need this. Okay. I can't believe Killa was up there. What a way to start off the season. Stay pretty far away from the sawmill here. I think we'll just cut through checkpoint. Now, right at the end of that raid, you could hear an airdrop coming. Airdrops have been fixed in 3.5. In Season 1, they were not available. So we are going to be able to grab airdrops. And the helicopter crashes are still in. That mod did get updated. So we'll have airdrops and helicopter crashes. Plenty of ways to get loot. What the hell was that? I'm also playing with brand new AI spawn points and patterns, so there is a very real chance that I'm going to run into scavs or PMCs in really weird places. Oh my god, it feels so good to run forever. Not immediately be tired. All right, here is the USEC camp. We're gonna loot this bad boy. And then pretty much just cut immediately right and head to the letter. See if we can find anything useful up here. See what we got. T. PRS. Okay, that was all useless. Keep hearing stuff. It's just my imagination. No Bitcoin? Didn't mean to push that. Okay. Definitely need matches. Don't need to grab that yet. M4? Nope. Ooh. Looking for Salewa. That was not a Salewa. There's an MP5 here we can grab too. Alright, I'm officially like full. Go ahead and head to the other part here. Again, checking for Slaywas. I think we're just gonna not go to the bunker and we'll just head back. To get the Jaeger letter. Still gonna check out the FOB though. Have a higher chance there of getting Salewas. Serve kit. I kind of want to take that. I do need the pile of meds for med station one. That's actually going to be more important. M4. Ooh, there's an M4. Sick. Can I change this out? Hold on. Yeah, I can. More suppressors. Okay. I think we're good on like random loot. Let's go get the letter and then hit the FOB looking for Salewas. We can check the crash as well. The plane crash near Jaeger's letter. High chance of getting medical items there. The reason why I'm grabbing all like the suppressors and sights and stuff is it gives me a little bit of money padding. We found out last season pretty early on that I run out of money real fast because I die a lot. So being able to sell all the suppressors and stuff is going to be nice. Am I going the right freaking way? No, I'm not. Alright, I got myself a little turned around. That's okay. I'm back. We'll just follow the plane crash. Get the letter. If we find a couple Salewas like we did last time on the plane crash, I might just leave. It's been very quiet. Which I dislike immensely. Alright, here's the plane crash. We're not gonna get nearly as lucky. Ow! It was so good! Just immediately two slaves. Oh well. No such luck this time. All right. Got the letter. Let's go check out the FOB. I'm gonna be able to see shit from here. YOLO! Please don't kill me. Damn, you can almost make that in like one run. So we're just looking for Salewas in here, nothing else really. Oh, here's somebody. Not hearing things, right? Maybe I am. Soap. I eat this hot rod. What we got here? That's a lot of pills. No Salewas. That sells for money. I'm not gonna worry about that. Med tools. I think I need those as well. What the hell is this? Blue blood? That's new. New to me. Alright, there's one more med crate we can check. There's a grizzly. I knew somebody was here. Woo! Woo! What? What? From where?
I'm leaving.
Oh, where'd you die, bro? Did I not? Nani? Ah! Do you have any salivas? Ooh, BS ammo. Let's do this. Oh, that's not gonna work, is it? Ah, shit, never mind. I do hear gunshots. All right, let's go. One more box, hold on. Pushing my luck. Oh shit, I need a syringe too. Okay. Alright, we're leaving. Alright, where do we need to go? Take the roadblock. Oh, it is open. Sick. Sick. Hello. All right, successful raid. We got the letter. No scav kills and no salewas, but that's okay. Just gonna dump our bag, turn these quests. Now Jaeger wants food. So maybe we go to Interchange? All right, we're going to go into Interchange, try and grab the food for Jaeger, and maybe grab some extra meds, possibly. I don't know if we can find Slewas easily without, like, the pharmaceutical keys, but we can check upstairs and check some bags and stuff and see if we can find those Slewas. So I'll see you guys in Interchange. Hello, Interchange, my old friend. Nice to see you here again. Ooh. So we can go right up into Goshen. Should be nice. As you can see, also, I've removed the better lights and lasers mod. As clear as the flashlights were, they were a little kind of overpowering just because, you know, how bright they were on the screen and how much real estate they took up on the screen. So we've gone back to just vanilla flashlights. They're not the greatest, but they do the job. So while we're in here, let's go ahead and check the ammo. What the hell? Is that an actual TOS? Oh, it's like a, like, not quite. We need a TOS for Skier eventually. But that's not really a TOS. It's the shell of one. Ooh, blackout. Oh, I forgot to check the black plastic crate out on the street. That's okay. I went the wrong way. These crates generally have iskras in them. I got jebaited super hard there. Let me check the crates up top, too. There's a bag back here. salt. I think salt's needed for nutrition unit. Oh my god, being able to jump that without having to wait a billion years. So nice. Might grab that B10 handguard just for future use. And right now it'll kind of serve as like a, you can attach stuff to it as you pick it up. Things like flashlights and rail guards and stuff. Don't think I need to focus too much on tech stuff, but we will grab any hideout items we can find or things we know are kind of difficult to search for. Three nippers, I think, are used for shotgun? No, you need the elite pliers, not nippers. Get out of here. I don't need you in my life. I think you can trade them, though. Or craft them? I don't remember. Don't need any of this yet. Nope. I botched that shot. Botched that shot. Are you just hiding? Bro, where'd you go? Nothing. There's no way I hit that shot. The frick? This dude's gonna jump scare me.
That was killer again, wasn't it? Ow! I'm not used to their new voice lines. Norty just ate that bullet. It did nothing. What? It didn't even say I hit him? Rough. Absolutely got destroyed. And that is going to do it for the first episode of Season 2 for the Single Player Tarkov series. My name is Frost. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed that video, feel free to give it a like and leave me a comment below. Tell me what your favorite moment was. If you've enjoyed the content on the channel so far, feel free to subscribe and turn on those notifications. I'll see you next time.